إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأزواجه وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وسلم تسليما كثيرا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله، اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. All praise is due to Allah. We praise Allah. We ask Allah's assistance and we seek Allah's forgiveness and we seek refuge in Allah from our evil souls and our bad deeds. Verily, whomever Allah guides to Islam, no one can lead astray. And whomever Allah allows to go astray because they do not want any guidance, then no one can guide. And I bear witness that there is no God or deity worthy of our worship except Allah alone with no partners. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his servant and his messenger. May Allah send his peace and his blessings and exalt his mention, that of his wives, his companions, and all those who follow them on their righteous path until the day of judgment. All you who believe, have taqwa of Allah the way he deserves it. And do not die except in a state of submission as Muslims. Brothers in Islam, there's a battle that is going on today. A competition. A major battle. But it has some characteristics unlike the ones we are used to. It is not a battle that is confined or restricted to a geographical location such as during war, where two countries or otherwise will be fighting on some land. That's one form of battle. It is not like the ones we see in sports on some sort of field or playground. Not that kind of battle either. It is not the one that you see in a wrestling or a boxing match in a ring. It is not restricted or confined to such a location, a place or time. It is beyond that. It is a battle or a competition that is more serious than that. Much more serious. And the difference as well is that each and every one of us and those who came before us and those who will come after us will partake in this battle, in this competition. No choice. Usually, you're given a choice. You may compete, you may retreat. But in this particular battle, brothers, we don't have a choice. We are in it. We are living it. We are experiencing it at this very moment. What is this battle? What is this competition? It is that of the dunya and the akhirah. The battle between this worldly life and the hereafter, the life to come. And as every battle, there's usually a winner or a loser. Sometimes they come out even, it's a tie. Don't worry about the brother and the fan. You came here to listen to the khutbah, not to see a brother move the fan. Don't let the shaitan be so dominant over you, my brothers in Islam. Have some strength. This is a reminder of the Quran and the Sunnah. So we must pay attention to the Quran and the Sunnah regardless of the speaker. The fan is going to stay there. Or it may go away. But the speech may take you to Jannah or Jahannam. So make sure you pay attention to what is being said. This battle is serious. And this is a manifestation of what I'm talking about. This is the house of the hereafter. This is where you invest in the hereafter. But some of us are still concerned with the dunya. The world has overtaken our minds and understandings. See, each and every one of us, if he's a Muslim for real, he will understand. He will believe in this battle. But the problem is not in believing. The problem is in striving to be successful. And I ask you, and you don't need to answer me, who is supposed to win? Who is supposed to win this battle between the life, this worldly life and the hereafter? Isn't it supposed to be the hereafter? Yes, indeed. The question then is, where are the brothers who are striving? Where are the brothers who understand and live accordingly? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taught us in the Quran this reality. But see, nowadays we only read the Quran. So someone could say, MashaAllah, Makharij al-Huruf, his recitation, the way he pronounces the letters, so beautiful. That's it. He recites nicely, huh? He has a lot of the Quran memorized and all the good and dandy stuff. But then ask the brother, Akhi, where is the implementation of this in your life? It may be absent. So we read the Quran, we read these verses. Have you read Surah Al-Isra? Have you read Surah Al-Isra once in your life? Did you come across these verses in the Quran? مَنْ كَانَ يُرِيدُ الْعَاجِلَةَ عَجَّلْنَا لَهُ فِيهَا مَا نَشَاءُ لِمَنْ نُرِيدُ ثُمَّ جَعَلْنَا لَهُ جَهَنَّمَ يَصْلَاهَا مَذْمُومًا مَدْحُورًا وَمَنْ أَرَادَ الْآخِرَةَ وَسَعَى لَهَا سَعْيَهَا وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنُ فَأُولَئِكَ كَانَ سَعْيُهُمْ مَشْكُورًا. Have you read these verses? And if you read them in Arabic, did you bother to see what they mean in the language of your mother tongue? Did you bother to see what they're talking about? Allah knows best. Who amongst us are among these individuals? In case you haven't, allow me to take the pleasure to deliver it to you at your own convenience and comfort while sitting down. Allah told us the reality of this dunya and the hereafter. Allah says, interpretation of the meaning in English, whoever wants this quick transitory life, quick passing life, this worldly life, Allah says, we shall readily give him. We shall readily give him whatever we want to whomever we will. Whatever we want. You want a lot of dunya? You may get a lot of dunya. To whomever Allah wills. This is in the dunya. But then Allah says, but in the hereafter, we will prepare for him the hellfire, where he will enter therein disgraced and humiliated. You get the dunya, but that means that you gave victory to the dunya over the hereafter. So there's no second round. There's no getting up from that knockout. That is the knockout that you don't rise after, my brother. No water can help. No doctor can help. No brother can help. No mother can help. No one can help. Once you knocked out, you knocked out. And then you will enter Jahannam. We seek refuge in Allah from Jahannam. That's for the one who won the worldly life. But then the verse continues, because the human beings are always of two kinds. Believers and then disbelievers. Then among the believers, there are those who understand and implement, and those who don't. As for those who do, Allah says, and whoever wants the life to come, al-akhirah, the life in the hereafter. But hold on, look at the wording in the hadith, in the ayah. وَسَعَى لَهَا سَعْيَهَا. عَمَل is work. سَعِي is striving. Striving. And he strives with the necessary effort due. وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ. Whilst he's a believer, then those, their deeds will be appreciated and rewarded in the hereafter. Look at the wording. سَعَى. Strive. You must strive. And where are the brothers who are striving? Where are the brothers who understand the value of this life? Allah tells us in the Quran that this life is insignificant. وَفَرِحُوا بِالْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا فِي الْآخِرَةِ إِلَّا مَتَاعٍ. And they rejoice the life of this world. They rejoice it, they enjoy it. But Allah says, and verily, the life of this world compared to the hereafter is nothing but fake, fake temporary pleasure. And today Muslims don't seem to understand this. We don't seem to understand this, my brothers in Islam. This is the most important thing to understand in your life. Where your destination is relevant to this understanding today. Isn't it time that we give the right of Allah? Isn't it time that we fulfill the obligations? Isn't it time that we prioritize?